हेलो, माय नेम इज़ तस्नीम इज़ी। आई एम लीगल इंटर्न एट लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी। माय टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ साइबर क्राइम। द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ साइबर क्राइम इज़ वेरी प्रॉब्लमेटिक। द फर्स्ट डिफिकल्टी इज़ टू प्रोवाइड अ डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ साइबर क्राइम, एज एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम देर इज़ नो यूनिफॉर्म और यूनिवर्सली एक्सेप्टेड डेफिनेशन। द टर्म साइबर क्राइम्स इज इनवेरिबली यूज्ड विद द कंप्यूटर क्राइम्स, कंप्यूटर मिसयूज और आईटी क्राइम्स। This is the reason that instead of using the expression computer crime, the current trend is including computer related crimes. Second is the lack of the authoritative and quantitative data, reliable quantitative data that provide full overview of cyber crime is unavailable. According to the UN Manual, law enforcement official indicates that recorded computer crime statistics are not an accurate reflection of the actual number of crimes committed using ICT. Two reasons are given for the absence of sufficient data on cyber crimes. The first reason is technological and is based on enormous storage of capacity and the speed of computers, which make it very difficult to detect computer crimes. Some victims are not aware that they have been a victim of a cyber crime until the moment they have been informed. The second reason is that investigating official often lacks sufficient knowledge and training in the field of electronic data processing and its complex environment. However, computer crime can be defined as deliberate action to steal, damage or destroy computer data without authorization, as well as accessing a computer system and account without authorization. Cyber crime is most dangerous of all crimes because of the magnitude of the loss it is causing today and its potential, the ease with which it is committed, its invisibility and the disregard for geographical boundaries, the difficulty in investigation, collection of evidence and the successful prosecution of cyber criminal, and the cost of dealing with cyber crimes by law enforcement and protective technology. Once the internet becomes an integral part of daily life of even the common man, which is not very far away, cyber crime, if not checked, would be destructive to civilization itself. Therefore, the growth of the internet should be directly linked with the growth of the protective technology and other means to check cyber crime. It would be futile for the internet culture to grow without effective means of checking cyber crimes. It will be in the interest of the society for the internet and e-commerce to grow slowly but steadily, rather than grow in a bubble only to burst. Characteristics of cyber crimes. Silent in nature. Computer crimes could be committed in the privacy of one's home without the need of physical presence. There is no signs of physical violence or struggle at the scene of crime, no cry of pain, etc., which are unusual hallmark of traditional crimes. Computer crimes can be committed with a click of the mouse, without the knowledge of the victim, but leaving him totally incapacitated. The victim, in most of the cases, will not even realize what has hit him. The blow would be swift, silent, and with a killer punch. Global in character. The operational canvas in a cyber computer crime is vast, and criminals respect no national boundaries. Sitting comfortably afar of country, the entire economy of another nation could be destroyed. Old concept of jurisdiction in crime investigation has become irrelevant, as a whole world could be the crime scene in a network crime. Non-existence of physical evidence. In the case of cybercrime, the crime scene does not yield any such physical evidence to indicate that the crime has been committed. The place remains clean and tidy, and there is no sign of disturbance. It is the digital format, that is, in the form of zeros and ones. It needs special trained hands to identify, recover, analyze, and infer the digital evidences. Creates high impact. though the traditional crimes may inflict heavy damages to the victim, he is not totally devastated by it. In the case of bank robbers, for example, the quantum of losses is constrained by the weight and the volume of the currency that can be carried away by the burglars. The amount burgled does not close down the bank operations permanently. The chances of robbery taking place against in the same bank are remote, since it is possible to take suitable precautionary measures and revamp the security of the bank. Disclaimer: that this video doesn't solicit any type of promotion or advertisement as per the guidelines of Bar Council of India, and the sole purpose of this video is for educational purpose only. Thank you.